It's amazing, Austin.
Trying to do something and really trying to spark the idea of positivity in the community. Let me tell my story. Let me tell other stories that's out here that want to do something different but can't, because you're in an environment where you just got to adapt. And what happens is it invites people in to get another perspective. It brings a whole another side of the world to this backyard right here and say, okay, these are actually people.
We'd like to go outside the city of Manila, away from its big buildings and harbor, and out to the peaceful farm countryside of the Philippines. One morning, you might find farm people you'd like to visit. People like this man on the water buffalo. If we could spend a day with him, what do you suppose he'd tell us about the Philippines? Let's listen to him.
We always get ready for work early, while the day is cool in my village. My barrio, as we call it. I see my neighbor Pablo is getting ready to go to his rice field. He too has a water buffalo. What we call a carabao. Carabaos are used for doing heavy work, hauling loads, plowing fields and such. Although another of my neighbors, Cesar, has a modern tractor he uses in his large rice fields. Other neighbors of mine take the village bus to go shopping in the next barrio or to plantations where they work. Before I, too, go to work, I usually have breakfast at my house. I build it high above the damp ground of strong bamboo and nipa leaves which grow nearby. In our open kitchen, I see my wife Dolores is making breakfast. There is plenty of fresh fruit, papayas and mangoes from the trees around us. And we have, steaming hot rice from my rice fields, of course.
To visit someone living in the Philippine Islands, you would probably go first to Manila, the biggest city in the Philippines.
Simulan natin ang aksyon sa mga nahuli. Sa Maynila, ang nakakabahala 8 sa 11 nahuli mga minor de edad. Nakunan sa CCTV ang kumpulan ng mga kabataan sa footbridge na ito. Sa Maynila mag-aalas 10 kagabi, ilang saglit pa, natataranta silang nagtakbuhan. Pero na-corner pa rin sila ng mga pulis na dumaan sa makabilang dulo ng tulay. Pinaupo sila at saka in-inspeksyon. Ayon sa mga pulis, nagatanggap sila ng reklamo mula sa barangay na nakita sa CCTV ng grupo.
Pagpunta nga po nila doon, bakit pala sila ng footbridge? Naamoy na nila yung usap ng marihuana. At nagpulasan po yung mga kabataan, pero nagsalipong po yung dalawang yung habang ng pulis natin at nasa mountain po sila.
11 kabataan ang nahuli. 8 sa kanila ay edad 12 hanggang 17 anyos. Na-recover sa kanila isang sachet ng hinihinal at paraphernalia. Tambayan daw ng mga nahuli ang footbridge para sa pagbibig.
Sa footbridge, siguro alam nila na hindi sila makikita doon. Makikita nga agad nila pag maparating.
Thank you.